Do you know what you're eating? Do you really know? You may think you do, but you've been lied to your entire life. Now I know this may be hard to stomach, but a lot of the foods that you're eating are fake. This is known as food fraud. Honorable judges, fellow competitors, and agricultural enthusiasts, my name is Taya Dronzek. Food fraud, defined by the Canadian Food Inspection Agency, is the deliberate and intentional substitution, addition, tampering, or misrepresentation of food, food ingredients, or food packaging for economic gain. There are many ways in which food fraud can be displayed. One way is through the use of substitution. Substitution is where you label a product as something that it isn't. For example, labeling a certain fish as a different fish. Another example is a food product that fails to meet certain standards by adding ingredients without mentioning it on the packaging. Making false claims on the packaging, such as saying that a certain product has health benefits when it doesn't, is also food fraud. To start, let's take a look at nature's sweetener, honey. Did you know that honey is the world's most fraudulently traded item according to the Canadian Honey Council? In the last decade, there's been an increase of honeys mixed with either rice or corn syrups. One way they tell the difference between natural honey and honey with additives is how fast it flows. Depending on the moisture content, natural honey will flow much slower than a honey with a syrup. It's alarming to think that more than 23% of imported honey products tested by the Canadian Food Inspection Agency contained additives despite being labeled pure. A big labeling problem that happens in the food industry is falsely labeling products as gluten-free. The number of products designated gluten-free is exploding. But can you trust every claim? There's over dozens of gluten-free claims, such as no gluten, without gluten, free of gluten, and no gluten ingredients used. Many people have celiac disease. Celiac disease affects estimated 1 to 100 people in the world. For patients with celiac disease, exposure to gluten in their diets can cause symptoms such as nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, and in some cases, damage to their intestines. My sister has a sensitivity to gluten, and we can always tell when she's eating something with gluten in it. Labels play a huge role in anything that we buy. New York's Columbia Medical Center conducted a recent study which found that pizza and pasta dishes were the biggest offenders, labeling the products as gluten-free but in fact, there was still gluten in the products. For products to be labeled gluten-free, they must contain less than 20 parts per million of gluten. One thing that always cracks me up are food products that are labeled gluten-free, which are naturally gluten-free, such as bottled water or sun-dried tomatoes. However, legally, they may be labeled gluten-free. One of the most common products exposed to food fraud is olive oil. Did you know that 80% of Italian olive oils are fraudulent? Most experts say that the bigger problem is the poor quality of the oil. Many include different additives, such as hazelnut oil, walnut oil, sunflower oil, and even peanut oil. Not only is the label lying to the consumer, but many people are alerted to what's being added into the oils. What can you do? You can seek out specialty olive oil shops or farmers markets where you can possibly try before you buy. Why should we care about food fraud? Well, as consumers, we expect that the packaging will tell us exactly what we're eating. We expect that what we're buying is what we're getting. Not knowing exactly what's in food can also cause serious health effects if the consumer is allergic to what's being added. You can prevent yourself from being a victim to food fraud by asking yourself these four questions. One, what is the product? And to be aware when buying certain items. Two, can you tell the quality? Three, is the price too good to be true? And four, are you buying from a trusted seller, such as local farmers markets? Farmers are very important to support. They help the environment, give you insight onto where your food is coming from, and you can help support local family farms. Buying local protects the environment because a lot of the food that at the grocery store has traveled over 1,500 miles just to get to your plate. The shipping of the item uses lots of fuels that contribute to pollution and even more environmental damage on the packaging used. Buying local also gives you insight onto where your food is coming from. By going to local farmers markets, you're able to talk to the farmers and make that farmer-to-consumer connection. You're able to ask questions about how your food is being produced. A quick Google search of farmers markets in my area will give you a massive list of places you can go and the times of operation. To go even broader than that, you can search up farmers markets in my province for a full list. New technology on the horizon is DNA barcoding, which would allow researchers to test a product by knowing the genetic makeup so meat, fish, and fresh produce can be assessed. A new smartphone barcode app might also soon be an option. I love the fact that we, as consumers, can take control back. And remember, what you don't know can hurt you. Take action. Thank you.